welcome back to my video part number 7. Okay, so in the last video, so we have discussed the ether hypothesis, right? So what is that ether hypothesis, you understood? So it is a kind of medium. So in the space there may be a medium, so in which all celestial bodies are moving, and you have discussed some properties of ether also. It is a constant medium, okay? It is not giving any resistance for the motion of any celestial bodies, etc. Okay, if you are finding the motion of any celestial bodies, you have to consider the motion of all the celestial bodies with respect to ether as an inertial frame, right? Now, so to prove the existence of ether medium, so there are so many experiments conducted. As I told, there are so many experiments conducted. Out of that, so Michelson-Morley experiment was the famous experiment. Okay, so with the help of this experiment, we can try to understand whether ether medium exists in the space or not. Okay, that's why aim of the experiment. You can just try to understand first what is the aim of experiment. See, the aim of the Michelson interferometer experiment was to prove the existence of ether. That means whether ether is present or not. Okay, in order to prove that, we are conducting this experiment by finding the velocity of drift between the ether and the earth. Okay, so they are trying to find the motion of the earth with respect to ether as a inertial frame. Okay. And even velocity of light also. So they can determine the velocity of light and velocity of earth both with respect to ether as a inertial frame. Okay. So with that aim, so they have taken the some kind of experimental arrangement here. So where we are assuming that earth is moving with respect to ether as inertial frame. So what is the velocity of the earth, you know? Velocity of the earth with respect to ether as inertial frame is taken as 3 into 10 to the power of 4 meter per second. And what is the velocity of light? C is equal to 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second. So these velocities of earth and velocity of light are actually determined with respect to ether as a inertial frame, with respect to that frame of reference as ether. Now let us try to see what is the changes will happen when it is determined in two different directions. So this is one particular direction, experimental arrangement you can see here. This is one particular arrangement in a particular direction. Okay. Suppose if it is rotated through 90 degree, what are the changes will happen? Okay. So this is basically optical experiment where we can see the formation of fringes. I think you heard about the fringes. So like alternate bright and dark fringes are formed when the superposition of two or more light waves take place. Okay. The monochromatic light waves, when they superimpose each other, so you get the fringes called interference fringes, right? Now to get that kind of fringes, so this is the experimental arrangement, clear? Now, so to get the monochromatic light, so we have the laser source here. Okay, the narrow beam of laser light is allowed to fall on a inclined glass plate. Okay, so this inclined glass plate G is actually a half silvered glass plate. You have to consider it as a half silvered because the front surface is half silvered here. So it is not completely reflecting the light when it is inclined at 45 degree in the upward direction. Okay, so it is reflecting partial light. Okay, so remaining partial light is transmitted through the glass plate. In that way, we can use this glass plate as a beam splitter. Okay, it gets the lights into two parts here. So beam splitter happens here, reflected wave and transmitted wave. Clear? So that is the function of glass plate here, of silvered glass plate. And then look at the on both the directions of the beam splitting. So we have two mirrors here. So one of the light gets transmitted through the glass plate and passes in the same direction. So we have a mirror here, okay, at the distance d. Okay, the mirror m1 is actually fully silvered, so complete light has to reflect back into the same path but in opposite direction. So this is the reflected ray moving in this direction, and after reflection by the mirror M1, it is moving opposite direction with the same path. Clear? So that is the function of the mirror M1 here. And similarly, the reflected light from the glass plate G is moving in the upward direction, I said. Okay? So there is another mirror M2. So this mirror M1 and M2 are exactly perpendicular to each other at equal distance. You can see that they are at equal distance here, D. Okay? And the reflected light by the mirror M2 is again moving in the opposite direction, okay, in the same path but in opposite direction. So these two reflected rays from mirror M1 and M2 will meet at the point O again. So the reunion of the light waves take place, or you can say superposition of two light waves take place. And you know the concept of interference. So when the two light waves of same amplitude, same frequency and same wavelength, when they interfere each other, they will form the interference fringes, correct? So that is what actually we are getting here. This kind of alternate bright and dark fringes are formed. Okay, so due to the two reflected waves by mirror M1 and M2. So that kind of fringes can be observed by using a telescope T. Okay, so final emergent ray are passing through the telescope. So these two reflected rays are forming the fringes. So we can observe the fringes using the telescope, as I said, exactly. It is kept exactly below the glass plate G. Okay, so that is the experimental part. Now you just observe the movements. So I said this experimental setup is kept on the stationary position on the earth surface. Okay, so if you assume that earth is stationary, then there is no changes in the arrangement like M1, M2 and reflections, everything. But earth itself, suppose if you assume earth itself is moving, okay, of course earth is a moving celestial bodies. Okay, so if earth is moving with a velocity 3 × 10⁴ meter per second, okay, with respect to the earth as inertial frame, then consider the movement of the entire system here. How it is moving? So M1 mirror position is moving to M1 dash, okay, so that the reflecting point at A changes to A dash, and here, so the light has to reflect back from mirror M2, isn't it? But when the light is traveling from O to M2, by that time mirror M2 is moving to position M2 dash, okay, the reflection occurs instead of B, the reflection occurs at now B dash, okay, the light is traveling in this direction like this now. Okay, so with what velocity? So I said velocity of light is 3 × 10⁸ meter per second, isn't it? That is C. So with that velocity, the light is moving from O to B dash. So what is the time taken by the light now? That is T dash. Okay, then the distance O B dash is equal to much C T dash. Okay, while traveling the upward direction towards the mirror. And then once it gets reflected back towards the glass plate. So at that time, glass plate already shifted from G to G dash. Okay, that is all because of motion of the earth. Okay, so M1 is shifting to M1 dash, M2 is shifting to M2 dash. At the same time, glass plate G also shifting to G dash. Clear? So at the position G dash, this glass plate G dash is receiving the reflected light by the mirror M2 at O dash now. Okay, so B dash, O dash distance is again equal to C T dash, because light is taking the same time T dash and moving the same velocity C while reflecting back also. Is it clear? The distance O B dash is equal to C T dash, and distance B dash O dash is measured in terms of again C into T dash, the velocity into time is the distance again, correct? Okay, after this experimental observation of the formation of the fringes, okay, we have certain theory. You have to calculate what is the actual time taken by the by the glass plate while it is traveling from O to B dash and B dash to O dash, and similarly O to A dash and A dash to O. So the time interval you have to calculate and see the time difference. What is the time difference between them? So, and then further we are going to continue the experiment by rotating the entire system through 90 degree so that they will interchange, the mirrors are interchanging. M1 will come here and M2 will come here, like that they interchange the positions. Okay, and then also there is a formation of fringes. Okay, so there is a comparison between the fringes. The theory part, you have to compare the fringes. So after rotating through 90 degree, some kind of fringe shift is expected. Okay, theoretically. So if the same thing is observed experimentally, then we can say that ether exists in the space. If there is no fringe shift occurs, then the experimental aim is actually not success. So it is a negative result of the experiment, you can say. So let us see whether we will get the positive result or negative result. If it is a positive result, then ether exists with respect to in the space, so that the earth is moving with respect to ether. If you get the negative result, then the motion of the earth with respect to earth concept is wrong. So that we can say earth does not exist. So that was the experiment here. Okay, so I think that theory part we will discuss in the next video. Okay, see you in the next video then.